Why are my revisions visible in Word? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Let's dive right into this occasionally embarrassing question. When I send out a Word document to others in my organization, they can see all the changes I've made. Everything I've deleted is struck out but still readable. They complain that it makes the document really hard to read, and I'm concerned that they're seeing possibly sensitive information. How do I stop it from happening? Honestly, I actually see this fairly often. What you're encountering is the track changes or revision history feature in Microsoft Word. Let me show you what that's all about, how you can view it with and without the changes being visible, and perhaps most importantly, how you can get rid of those changes. So here we are in Microsoft Word. This happens to be the Gettysburg Address I'm going to use as my example. Normally, if we make changes, those changes just happen, right? You delete a paragraph and the paragraph is gone. However, Word has this feature called Track Changes. So I'm going to turn that on. Now, all that really does, it doesn't seem to have made any difference. However, what it does is now when I delete this paragraph, instead of actually removing it from the document, it just marks it as having been deleted. Any other change I might make, for example, I might change these two words into a single word because it's more current common English. Now you can see that, yeah, it doesn't look like much has changed. You still see the two words, but in reality, the space between them has this little line through it. And that means that the character has been removed from the document. Except it hasn't. It's still visible. So there are two things then that you need to know. One, you can look at the document with the changes not being displayed. So in up here in all markup, right next to the track changes option, we will click on that and we will say no markup. What that does is that shows us the document with all the changes applied and without all of the old content being visible. I suspect that that's what you're seeing, because it hasn't actually removed the old content. I can now go back to saying, you know, all markup, and sure enough, there are all the changes that we've made. There are two ways to deal with this, the traditional way and a new way that Word added some time ago that I'm actually going to recommend you use instead, but I want to show you the traditional way first. And that is simply this. Over here, there's this accept button. If you click on the dropdown and say accept all changes, boom, everything is gone. And in fact, there is no way to look at it again. If you save this document, those changes are no longer present. Now, I'm going to undo that because I want the changes to be in place for our next example. And that is simply this. On the File menu, in Info, click on Check for Issues near Inspect Document, and then click on Inspect Document. Of course, it's warning me that it's about to remove information from the document that we might want to see later. I get that. The way to work around that, if that's important to you, is to save one copy before doing this so that all of those changes are still there, and then have this other copy from which you are about to remove all the changes. We'll click on Yes. It does insist that we save the document, so I'm going to go ahead and save it. These are the kinds of things that the document inspector will look at. What a lot of people don't realize is that there's a lot of, I'll call it metadata, associated with your Word document. Some of it is the change history, absolutely. And that is in fact the very first item, comments, revisions, and versions. The next one is also kind of interesting, document properties and personal information. Your name could be going out with the documents that you send out, if you're sending out Word documents. That may be okay. That may be a surprise. That may be something else you want to see removed from the document. Nonetheless, the inspector will take a look at that and a bunch of other things and tell you what it finds. I'm going to go ahead and click on the Inspect button. And sure enough, there are two areas in this document where there is information that perhaps I might not want to include when I send that out. If I say remove all to comments, revisions, and versions, boom, all of the history of the changes that we've made to this document will be removed the next time we save it. And finally, for document properties and personal information, yeah, I don't want my name associated with this document. Remove all. Now I'll hit close, and the document has been updated. Now, when I save it, all of that personal information, including the stuff that you had been seeing, that folks had been complaining about, making it difficult to read, that's all gone. That is revision history in Microsoft Word. Now, I do want to point out that there used to be another way for information to be leaked. And if you've been using Word for a very long time, and we're talking 20 years here, there used to be a feature called Fast Save. That was probably responsible for even more information leakage than the stuff we've covered so far. What Fast Save did is that rather than actually rewriting the entire document to disk, updating it with all of the changes you've made, it would instead simply append the changes to the end of the document. Logically, conceptually, so that the original document was still there, and then a list of things that had to be updated in the document, very much like the revision history that we've seen here. A lot of people didn't realize that was there. In fact, it was such a problem that in about 2003, one of the versions of Word that came out about that time, Microsoft actually removed the feature. Honestly, it was no longer necessary. The Fast Save feature was really a way to compensate for disk speeds perhaps not being as fast as we might want them to be. These days, that really isn't much of an issue, so that feature isn't there. But if you remember it, if you're wondering if that still applies, it no longer applies. What's more important is that you remove the file history, the revision history yourself before you save the document and before you send it out to others. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/2413. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.